Hi everyone, hope you are doing all right. So today we will be talking about the pathogens and immunity part number 2 by Science Time IGCSE course. So before going to this video, I will be asking you to subscribe my channel. Don't forget to like and drop a comment, share my videos and my channel as much as possible for making me stronger so I can upload more videos and with a much more well-organized way. So let's go. A quick revision from part number 1, talking about the ways for the pathogens, indeed the transmissible pathogens, to enter our body, including contamination, airborne, vector and direct contact, and also discussing about the defenses of the body for not permitting and allowing and not letting the pathogens to enter the body, provided into 2 sections, including mechanical defenses, skin and nostril hairs inside our nose, and also chemical defenses, including mucus, which is being released by goblet cells, and the stomach acid, or in other words, hydrochloric acid. And also defining the term white blood cell, or by an abbreviation, WBCs, and providing it into 3 main parts, including lymphocytes, phagocytes, and macrophages with their own chemical properties and functions. So indeed, I will be recommending you checking out my last video, since it's pretty much very important for knowing the fundamental and basic informations about different types of pathogens and also different types of WBCs. So what is vaccination? How can we vaccinate? Vaccination is the process of recognition or the process of realization of the immune system due to a specific pathogen. And like, for example, in simple words, for example, we are going to a country, that country, there is like a bacteria or a prion or a virus, or also it can be also a parasite, which only spread it out in that country, in that specific country. So me, myself, I will be vaccinating myself. So the weakened, or let's say the dead form of that parasite, or let's say of that bacteria, will be injected in my body. And when I'm saying weakened, so in that case, it would be easy for the immune system to produce the lymphocytes, and those lymphocytes are going to release and produce those antibodies. And it's not going to be that much harmful. That means like a short-lasting process, and it's not going to be that much hard. It is not going to be that much harmful. So steps for vaccination, it's a weakened or a dead pathogen, or also the toxic materials of that pathogen, is going to be injected inside the body by an apparatus. The normal infection, as you can see in the picture, the vaccination process, the normal infection is going to get involved, which in this case, B lymphocytes, or let's say B cells, that we will be talking about them in our upcoming videos, are going to attach the antigens. The antigens are those foreign proteins on the surface of those pathogens, for becoming activated, or let's say for becoming memory cells, so they can produce that certain antibody for ingesting and destroying the pathogen. So now, as I'm talking about lymphocytes, their functions, memory cells, or in other words, activated lymphocytes, I explained all these things in details in my last video in part number 1. So indeed, check it out and don't forget to subscribe. And the third step, from that moment onwards, that those B cells, or let's say that B lymphocytes, release and produce those that certain antibody for destroying and ingesting that certain pathogen. So from that moment onwards, whenever the same pathogen, don't forget this, enters the body, the antibodies are going to be immediately released. from those activated lymphocytes, or let's say from those memory cells. Because whenever lymphocytes, they gain enough information from a new pathogen, that unactivated lymphocyte will become activated. Therefore, it will store all those informations that it took from that pathogen. So this is because the body is going to become immune due to that specific and certain pathogen. And now COVID-19. So the same thing for COVID-19. When we vaccinate, the weakened or the dead form of that virus known as COVID-19 will be injected to us, as you can see in the right picture. So in that case, we can ensure, that means we will be sure that our body became immune due to that certain pathogen. When I'm saying the body became immune due to that pathogen due to COVID-19, means that if we get COVID-19 again, we won't feel sick at all. Because the reason, the exact reason, is because the memory cells for COVID-19 was being produced at the first time. So therefore, whenever COVID-19 enters our body, that virus enters our body, indeed, the antibodies will be released immediately. And now, immunity, which is pretty much very important, being provided into two parts, active immunity and passive immunity, and each immunity is being provided into natural immunity and artificial immunity. So, we will be discussing about them in the next second. So the natural active immunity is the same infection. That means nothing is being injected. Like the normal pathogen, like a parasite or a protozoa or a prokaryot or a prion, and also or a virus will enter the body by different ways, and the same process will get involved. The immune system, or let's say the WBCs, in this case the B cells, the B lymphocytes, or even phagocytes, in this case, as an example, for instance, we will be talking about B cells. As these B cells, B lymphocytes, they will be attaching the foreign antigen on the surface of each pathogen in this world. So in that case, the B cells, they will be gaining enough information from those antigens, from those foreign proteins, coming inside the body from outside, from external. And as they gain information, they will be converted into activated lymphocytes. They will be converted into memory cells. So in that case, they will be storing all those informations that they got from that foreign antigen. After that moment, they will be releasing and producing antibodies, a certain antibody for ingesting and destroying that specific pathogen. So a normal infection. And now artificial active immunity, which is the same thing, but in this case it will be injected. But now, which is well known as vaccination, as we talked about it in our last slides, that the pathogen is not going to enter the body spontaneously. It is going to be injected inside the body by using the vaccine in the picture. So in that case, the weakened form, or let's say the dead form of that pathogen, or even the toxic materials of that pathogen, will be injected inside the body. So the immune system will encounter these kind of things. So the lymphocytes, that means the same process, and the memory cells are going to be produced. But even though the majority of the IGCSE teenagers, they are saying that because they don't have enough awareness due to the term vaccination, they are all the times saying that the antibody will be injected by the vaccinate, the process of vaccination. But this is incorrect. Vaccination is only the process of recognition. It's only the process of realization of the immune system due to a specific pathogen. And now, natural passive immunity, which there is only one example for it, which is known as breastfeeding, which is only for females, When females, they will become, as a mom, they will have children. At first, they will be doing the process of breastfeeding. In that case, the maternal antibodies will be injected from another organism to another, to that baby, to that child. So in that case, we can say that in passive immunity, the antibody will be injected from another organism to another, or let's say the antibody, at least it is being injected from external. But in active immunity, as we explained, both natural and artificial, no antibodies are being injected. The normal infection and the memory cells will be produced. So natural passive immunity, breastfeeding, which in this case, the maternal antibodies will be released. That means it will come out from the mother's body to the baby's, or let's say that child's body. That means the antibody will be injected. And now the artificial passive immunity, which in this case, the monoclonal antibodies are going to be injected inside the body. So we notice that one of the most important and crucial disadvantages for passive immunity is that no memory cells are being produced. And most of you will be asking that why in passive immunity, no memory cells are being produced. This is because the antibody is already injected inside the body. Because if memory cells were going to be produced, that time has to be taken by those lymphocytes, by those B cells, for gaining enough information from those antigens, for becoming memory cells, and finally for producing antibodies. But now, the antibody is being directly injected, which means that the passive immunity, no difference, either natural or artificial, they are short-lasting, because the antibody is directly injected inside the body from another organism to another, or from external to internal. So, the differences between immunities. In active immunity, as I said, it is long-lasting because that time is going to be taken by B lymphocytes, by B cells, for gaining enough information from those foreign proteins. But in passive immunity, it is short-lasting because the antibody will be directly injected inside the body. So that time which is going to be taken by those B cells for gaining enough information, and the time which is going to be taken for producing those antibodies, is going to be completely eliminated from passive immunity. Because in, for example, in natural passive immunity, as the child is going to be born, he or she indeed needs antibodies, because in that moment, he or she doesn't have any antibodies. He or she doesn't have a complete immune system. So in that case, the mother has to give her antibodies to her child, indeed. In active immunity, the memory cells are being produced. Even though in passive immunity, no memory cells are being produced, which can be considered as the most crucial disadvantages for passive immunity. The last thing, in active immunity, the body produces its own antibodies for destroying and ingesting the pathogen. But in passive immunity, the antibodies are injected from another organism, or let's say in other words, from external to internal, which when injected, after doing their function, after like doing their job, it will be automatically destructed. It will be automatically eliminated and removed from the body. And why? Since it's being considered as a foreign protein. Like as I said, the pathogens, they have antigens on their surface, and those antigens are being considered as foreign antigens, foreign proteins. And why? Because they entered from external to internal. So in that case, these antibodies, which they came from another organism, which came from external to internal, it will be considered as a foreign protein, which is going to be destroyed after a moment. So we are done. Don't forget to subscribe, like, and drop a comment. Feel free to ask any educational questions that came to your mind. So see you in our next video.